Respected National President Khoya ji, National Director Arvind Rao Khidige, Senior Bharadwaj National Faculty Cell Chairman, Professor Dr. Matai, the Faculty Cell Coordinator. I'm very much happy and delighted to join this webinar series of Senior Chamber, and as already mentioned, it is a great idea and innovation that Senior Chamber has come forward with a wonderful idea during this troublesome and turbulent days of COVID. We're all having a lot of free time, and we have learned as JCs to utilize our time very, very effectively. Senior Bharadwaj has already given some rules and ground rules. I would like to repeat few things because people always violate the rules. I would ask all of you not to chat at this point of time. It will divert our attention because there is a chat box below the screen. There is also a mute on your extreme left because I think few of us don't know where this muting is. And the muting is on the extreme right. You can identify whether your laptop or mobile is muted or not. And the chat box should be used only when it is being announced, and because I want to utilize the chat box, because in the training, it's not a one-sided affair, it is not a monologue, but it is a dialogue. It is a concept of sharing and learning. It is not a one-sided affair because training has taken new dimensions. It is not a one-sided affair because I need the participation of the participants. But when we do it on the internet, definitely it can be done only through the chat system of the Zoom. And I need your cooperation during the time when I need your chat or your comments or your suggestions and your answers. I hope it is clear. Yes or no? Hello. Yes. I hope it is yes. Right? Now, we have a topic. And of course, as suggested by Advocate Sugathan, my great friend from my own Wayanad, he has been talking in glorious terms about my involvement as well as my commitment. Thank you, Advocate Sugathan, past National President, for your kind words. Now, it is getting 8 o'clock, and I always tell, today also I talk to National President Mohammed Khoya as well as Bharadwaj. When we conduct something, it should be with due seriousness. There may be people who just want to see how Zoom is, how their face appear, how to mute, all those things. But we want to see that we follow that procedure, the regulation and the discipline, which we call as the basic parliamentary procedure. Conducting training program in a group of people in an auditorium is an easy task. But I feel that conducting a training program in a website, in a webinar, is of course a tedious one because we cannot ensure the participation. I hope you remember the word I used. I used it as not as a speech, because nowadays there is no speech in the training system. It is a concept of sharing and learning. And I hope that today also we are going to have a sharing and learning, not a speech from my side. I think it is clear. Yes or no? Yes, I hope it is a big yes. Today, our topic is go for goals, going for goals, because I have selected this word of go for goals, because during my governorship about 20 years back in Lionism, my slogan was go for gold. Go for gold was a beautiful slogan which I coined at that time. But now when Senior Bharadwaj asked me to give the topic, I gave him the topic, go for goals. There is an ascending order. The first word is having two letters. Second is three letters. And the third one, of course, goals, having three, four, five letters. So it is an ascending order, going for the goals. Goal setting is the topic today. And I don't want to make a sermon on the mount about goal setting, but I want to give you some focus points on the concept of goal setting. Goal setting is not only applicable for a student. Goal setting is not applicable for a child. Goal setting is applicable even for a person of 60 years old, even for an age person beyond that age. Because in Senior Chamber, in our creed, we say we are the paragon of perfect citizenship. I'm sure each one of us who are members of the Senior Chamber knows that in our creed, we say that we are paragon of perfect citizenship. I don't know whether anyone of you have gone through the meaning of the word paragon. Paragon is a beautiful word which I have seen in dictionary, and the meaning of paragon, can anyone type in the chat box the meaning of paragon? Anyone please try, Bharadwaj, please monitor that.
Yeah.
Can you give the meaning of paragon in the chat box? You have the chat box below, there is a chat box. Can you see? In the chat box, you can type the meaning of paragon. I'll give you half a minute to write down the meaning of paragon, because paragon of perfect citizenship is in our senior chamber creed. Please write. It is your time. Okay, brothers, can you monitor that?
No chat has come so far.
Any answer? Paragon?
Perfect
okay.
Example.
Perfect, wonderful, wonderful.
Perfect example.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Who has given that answer? Perfect example?
Name.
Whose answer was that?
Vivo,
no problem.
Vivo camera. They want to say this is extreme.
Okay, fine. Paragon, the correct answer is given by somebody, I didn't get the name, and you deserve a chocolate because the training I always use chocolate. Yeah, who is that? Okay, fine, no problem. Okay, Piyamathai, fine. Piyamathai is an English professor and he know the meaning. Paragon means perfect example. It can be called as a model, and senior chamber members are supposed to be paragons of perfect citizenship. What a wonderful slogan. Our founder as well as the charter secretary has given the definition, our creed, the paragon of perfect citizenship. Goal is your source of energy. I would like to keep it as the keyword of today's discussion. Goal is your source of energy. In spite of the fact that, or irrespective of the fact that you are young or old, there should be a concept of goal setting. I know that in senior chamber, we have very senior people. People with the age of 40, we have 45, we have age of 60, even 70 members we have. So when we talk about goal setting, my first point is the first point to be communicated is applicable to each and everyone. So in short, goal is your source of energy. I would ask all these participants to kindly keep a writing pad and pen. If you don't have it, kindly get it, because I would ask you to note down some points. I would ask you to do some work also, because I have some assignments. Can you hear me? Hello. Can you hear me? Hello. Hi.
You're audible.
Can you hear? Audible or not?
Yes.
Yes, fine.
Yes.
You are very audible.
Audible.
Fine. So I would ask all our participants today to keep a writing pad or a sheet of paper as well as pen, because we have few activities. Please remember, this is not a snapshot training. I need at least 40 to 45 minutes to complete my task, because when we do something, it should be done with perfection. And that's what we have learned from the Jaisism. As Advocate Sugidhani has said, whatever I have learned in my life and career, it is through the Jaisi organization also. And this is a great organization that has provided me that lessons of perfection. So all of you requested to keep with you a writing pad as well as a pen, because we have to do some assignments. So I hope you will do that, right? Okay, fine. We are going to have a discussion today on goals and goal setting. First of all, we are going to discuss about the value of setting the goals. My slides are not moving. Slides.
It will take time. It will take, just press on it.
Okay.
It will take time.
Okay. Next slide.
First slide movement will take time.
It's not coming. Slide is not moving. Is it moving here?
Let me see.
Can you help me?
Sir, you slide can try unshare once and share again.
Okay, fine. I'll unshare now. Stop
unshare
sharing.
And share again.
Fine.
Stop sharing and yeah.
Yeah, I will come back again with sharing.
Select the second slide and go for sharing.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Be an archer. I hope coming. You can see yeah. that. Good. Be an archer. It is coming, no? Be an
it's
archer.
Coming. It's coming. Here. It's coming. Good.
Yes.
Wonderful. Be an archer. I would ask you to be an archer. What do you mean by archer? Can you just put in your chat box the meaning of the word archer? Can you put in your chat box? I want you to participate, please, because it is a concept of sharing and learning. I want you to share. I want you to share. Can you write down the meaning of archer in your chat box? Varghese will monitor that. He will tell me the meaning of that word archer. Any answers?
So far, none.
So far, none. Archer, meaning of ants.
Here is Udebanu saying yes. An arrow thrower.
A person who is an arrow thrower, fine. So an archer is a person who you are using, who is always using a bow and an arrow, no? A person who is a bower using a bow or an arrow. And as far as an archer is concerned, he's having a focus looking at the bird's eye.
Or looking at shooting.
It is shooting, it is focusing, and it is focusing our objectives, it is focusing our ideas. Archer is a beautiful word in the dictionary again. Archer means a person who is using his bow and arrow, and when he uses your bow and arrow.
Bindu has a definition, you put perfect aim to shoot, that is archer.
Exactly.
And Vikram says, one who uses tool, Rajesh says the correct tool. Aimer.
Correct aim or focus. I got the answer. Vikram, you deserve a chocolate now, right? You deserve a chocolate. Archer is Sugadhan a person.
Sugadhan has already done.
Yes, wonderful. That's a good sign of involvement that each one of you are participating, and that is a good sign of participation. And we always have the training program like this. I remember a person called E. Sridharan, who is called as the Metro Man. You know, Metro Man, E. Sridharan. Sridharan is a person who has always achieved his goal in his life. He is not a retired man. Of course, he is more than 80. I think he is having an age of about 80. Once in an interview by media people, and a question was asked to E. Sridharan, sir, you have been a very successful man. And can you tell me some method in which you operate? You have a good memory also. How do you do that? I remember one of the answer the Metro Man E. Sridharan has given is that in one of the particular point of discussion, he said, I always keep a pen and a diary or a small page in my pocket. Always, if it is in my house, when I'm doing a telephone or when I'm talking to somebody, I always keep a writing pad as well as pen, because I learn a lot. I keep note of everything. I always write things, and it's a great lesson for me. And he said it is something like a camel shoe, you know, camel shoe in the desert. No, the people travel for many days, long days. And when you travel for many days, there are some areas of greenery. And in that greenery, that's a place for exchange of water, food materials, foodstuff, bread, and etc. Once an old man, as well as his small child grandson, was walking through the forest. And you know, it's a process which takes so many days. And they were walking through the desert, not the forest, through the desert. And whenever this crossing over the desert in the scorching sun, this old man, the grandfather, used to pick up something from the sand. Usually in the desert, there are camels, you know. Camels are always found in the desert. And the camels will always lose their shoes, no? Camel, ladam in the marine. In Malayalam, we call it ottagath in the ladam. And this ladam is being, I mean it will, you know, as worn off, or it will go through the sand. And this old man, at every time, he'll pick up this old, you know, made of iron, the camel shoe, and he used to keep that camel shoe in his bag. So when during the travel of many days, every time this old man walks and then he sees a camel shoe, which is available in the sands of the forest, he picks up this camel shoe and he keeps in the pocket. And this youngster, the grandchild of this old man, was observing this carefully, and he could see that this old man was every time keeping this camel shoe in his bag. And this old man was doing that continuously. And at a particular point of time, the child or the boy asked the question, what are you trying to do every time you are taking this old rusty, it is in the soil for so many days, you are keeping this old camel shoe near that. What is the purpose? And this old man kept mum. He didn't speak for some time. But the boy happened to ask the question again, why you are picking up all this camel shoe all the time? And this old man did not reply. And they were walking for days, and at a particular point of time, they reached a point of greenery where some shade was there. That's a resting place. In fact, there's a word for that resting place in the desert, which I forgot. And they were resting at that point of time. There are so many.
Oasis, sir.
Oasis, absolutely. Thank you, Bharatji. Oasis, and there was a place of oasis selling some bread, some water, some food stuff and all. And this old man did, he purchased a bottle of water and exchanged. Instead of the money, he happened to hand over this old camel shoe, which is rusted. No, iron always rusts when it is exposed to air and atmosphere. So in turn or in exchange of water, he has exchanged the old camel shoe, which he has picked up from the sands of the desert. Likewise, you keep some points, do not only for the examinations. In your life and career, you will need a lot of camel shoe. And let us have these camel shoes in our time. We have this topic of goal setting. As somebody said, as you are given, it is like an archer. You have to focus your attention. You have to absolutely focus. And there are so many persons who have succeeded in their life and career. And coming to that point, goal setting is an absolutely important thing in everybody's life. Particularly, we live in the 21st century, you know, all of us live in the 21st century. And I used to tell in all the training sessions, we live in the age, which is called as in Google generation. Am I right? It's the Google generation. What do you mean by Google generation? Everybody sits in front of the TV. Now we are exchanging ideas through the network online. Every small child is having a mobile with him. There is internet. Previously, it was half 1 GB. Now everybody has 3 GB of memory in your mobile phone and your laptop and your house. So it is a Google generation. I hope all of you will agree with me. It's a time of Google generation. And in this Google generation, only those who are focused in their attitude, only those who have a clear objective are going to succeed. And in that way, I'm proceeding with my discussion on goal setting. I hope all of you can read. Can you read this slide? One of you, can you read this? To succeed, we need vision and action plan of our goal. Yes, irrespective of the age, irrespective of your profession, everybody need a vision and action plan. That's what we are going to do in this training session. It is not the pastime of excitement, my dear friends. It is a time for us to think about the goal, at least to have an idea about the goal. Today, we are going to define, I'll come to the next slide, the objectives of the session. Recognize the value of setting goals. Value. Now, value is a word that all of us know. It was done through the last year National President Bharatji also. The values. Value is something that should reverberate in our ears all the time. Value is a word of the Google generation of the 21st century. 21st century demands more experience. 21st century demands more exposure. And 21st century demands more expertise. I'm sure all of you listening to me, there are about 65 to 68 persons listening to me now. We need more exposure. Second one, what is that? Exposure and expertise in this Google generation of 21st century. So we should have to recognize the value of setting goals. As I'm repeating certain words all the time in this training seminar. Goal is your source of energy, and you have to recognize the value of setting your goals. So first of all, we are going to have an idea about the value of setting the goals. And of course, the next one is identifying the characteristics of setting the goal. Characteristics is a word that we usually repeatedly use. We have an English professor as a faculty cell coordinator. Always he can help me out with the answers in the chat box. Characteristics, because the chat box is visible to all of you, because I would ask you, the participants, to look at your chat box also in between. Characteristics mean the kind of the features of the main features or the main specialities. No, Matai, can you give me a beautiful word? Characteristics, Malayalam. In Malayalam, I can say it is prathegathagal, allekil vyathisthamaya attitude ennu veney parayam. Characteristics of goals. Okay, thank you. Savisheshatha. Identify the characteristics. That is what we are going to do today in the limited time. And now, what is the next? Can you tell me What is the next? We are going to create a set of goals. That's why I'm serious about the training session. This is not a pastime of excitement. Okay. I'm sure all of you are listening very, very carefully. I'm absolutely happy about it, right? I hope all of you are listening carefully. We are going to create a set of goals in the limited time of Indian Senior Chamber webinar. Each one of us, irrespective of our age, will create a set of goals. And the next, we are absolutely going to develop an action plan. Will you be able to do that? Yes, today. And the Indian Senior Chamber has come up with a wonderful initiative in the history of 22 years with a webinar. It should be a productive activity. You know the meaning of the word productivity. Again, I will ask Matai to help me out. Productivity, what is productivity? Can you put in your chat box? Productivity is a very important word of the present time. Yes, productivity meaning, Matai, productivity. I'm resorting to Matai again. Productivity, productivity.
Capacity to produce.
The capacity to produce. Yes, it is the outcome.
Ulpadan Shama.
It is the output. In the senior chamber, because we are all the products of JCs, we are all proud members of JCs. In senior chamber also, we focus on this concept of productivity. And productivity, as Vikram said, as Matai said, it is a concept of output. Now, when we have a seminar of 45 minutes, when we have a webinar of 1 hour, it should be productive. Otherwise, there is no meaning of conducting a webinar. Paradas, I've insisted to him to have this, purchase this for 1 month. We have 1 month opportunity for this, and a session can be 2 hours. So it must be productive. In that line, I would like to repeat, each one of you will develop an action plan. And this is what we are going to do in this session of 45 to 50 minutes. I just like to tell you about a girl whose name is Bino Zifine. Maybe few of you have heard about this girl, B-E-N-O, Bino Zifine, Z-D-P-H-I-N-A. Bino Zifine is a girl from Tamil Nadu. I think I have mentioned about this girl sometime back, because I remember this girl many times. This is a girl from Tamil Nadu, maybe 24 years old, and she obtained Indian Foreign Service. She graduated from the UPSC examination, I think in the year 2017 or 2016, UPSC batch. She got selection to Indian Foreign Service. As all of you know who are listening to me knows that the UPSC has different selection. One is the Indian Foreign Service, of course, the first priority. Then comes the IAS, then comes the IPS, then comes the other economic service, other administrative service, account service and all. But this girl was selected for Indian Foreign Service. I would like to tell you the story of this great achiever, this girl who achieved her goal in her life, Bino Zifine. And I have seen this accidentally in the national NDTV. That was 3 years back. Bino Zifine was interviewed by a person called, his name was Sardeshai. His name is Rajdeep Sardeshai. You know Rajdeep Sardeshai? Sardeshai is an anchor. He's a very famous journalist of India. His name is Rajdeep Sardeshai. He is currently, he's working for India Today, and he was the editor-in-chief of CNN, IBN, etc. Currently, this Rajdeep Sardeshai works for the Indian India Today. Formerly, he is working for India Today. I usually tell my friends who are attending my sessions, even to my students, that they should watch the TV. They should watch NDTV at least 30 minutes a day, because we are opening our doors to the world. Coming back to my point of this achiever, Bino Zifine. Bino Zifine was visually impaired. You know the meaning? Visually impaired. Visually impaired means she cannot see properly. Maybe partial vision is there. We won't use the word blind, because as we say, physically challenged, only we use the word physically challenged. She was visually impaired. Bino Zifine, the winner of IFS 4 years back, 3 years back, she was visually impaired. I'm coming to my point, because my story should not be length. As in trainers usually say, you always come forward with short stories for your illustrations. And this girl was interviewed by Sardeshai. Rajdeep Sardeshai is a name, very, very, very good personality. I like him. Even now I watch NDTV and he has so many presentations. He asked a question, and this girl of 24 years old from a village of Tamil Nadu was sitting in front of the channel NDTV, and Sardeshai was asking, happy welcome to the channel of NDTV. The whole globe is watching you. And this girl with her eyes, no, of course she cannot see, she was smiling. And he asked, Sir Beshai, ask the question that each one of you will ask to this girl, Dino Sifine. And that question was like this. That question I will also ask. How could you achieve this goal? Am I clear to you? The question given by Sardeshai to this girl who won IPSC, UPSC examination, maybe for the first time in the history of 60 years of Indian Union Public Service Commission, she won this IFS exam. And Sardeshai question shot at this girl from the village area of Tamil Nadu, who succeeded in IFS. How did you achieve this goal? I'm coming back, I'm drawing your attention to the answer given by this girl. She said, number one, my teachers motivated me to achieve this goal right from the days of my childhood, my primary school days. And I had that desire, decision and determination. And I had that goal in my life to achieve this. That is a goal setting of a blind girl. I don't use the word blind girl, a visually impaired girl from a small village area of Tamil Nadu, achieving the glory, the pinnacle of success, achieving success. And that's a natural question. And number one answer, she said, I have set a goal and I was motivated by my teachers right from my childhood days. And the second answer, the second part of the answer of this girl of 24 years old was, my parents provide me the environment. Listen carefully. The answer number two, my parents provided me the environment. Now, number one, I had the desire, determination, I had the goal. And the second answer, my parents provided me the environment. And third, she said, my teachers all the time were supporting me. Yes, this is a story of a girl who has achieved success, who has recognized the value of the goal, a visually impaired girl, because our children, our youngsters have a lot of opportunities, lot of money, a lot of energy, and they fail to achieve their goal. Yes, that is the objective of this session. I put 4 points, value of setting the goals, the characteristics of the goals, and to create a set of goals today, and of course, developing an action plan. Now, what is a goal? I would ask you to write in your chat box a definition for a goal. Can you write down, please, a brief one or two lines? What is a goal? This is the time for you. I give you half a minute only. Please write down in the chat box definition for a goal. Definition for a goal.
Why didn't people are becoming naughty? PNP says he is not interested in the chocolate, he is interested in the fruit. Fellowship, if you give him a prize. And there are a few people who, instead of chocolate, would like to have your fellowship coupon.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Yes, yes.
And here is what we have to achieve, says Dr. Yes. Shiv Kumar. And ultimate aim is from Richard Kumar says ultimate ambition and aim in life.
Ultimate ambition, fine, wonderful.
Then. And what we want to achieve, says Vikram.
What we want to achieve, fine. Okay, that's enough. Let us close the chat box now. I got a lot of answers, and that is a signal, that's a symbol that my there are so many participants for me, they are listening to me. Fine. Now you can see the second question in the slide. What is the value of establishing the goal? Can you say the value of establishing the goal? I'm giving the questions to you now. What is the value of establishing goals? My point is, as leaders, because senior chairman are very senior people, as leaders, it is not only your goal, but you have to motivate others also to achieve their goal. Am I right or wrong? I'm sure all of you will agree with me. It is not only your goals as a leader, because each and everyone sitting here is a leader. Yes or no? Are you a leader or not? Hello? I'm talking about you. Each one of you, 68 participants here. Everybody is a leader. And the leader, it is not only for a leader. You have to consider others also. Once in a circus tent, a trapeze artist was jumping from one end of the net of the trapeze circus net to the other end. You know, the trapeze artist is a person who is an expert and the trapeze artists, there are so many people coming in and jumping from one end of the net to the other end of the net, and that is how the trapeze artists perform. Now usually when we go to a circus, we'll wonder how this trapeze artist performs jumping from one end of the circus net to the other part of the net, and people holding hand and all. It's absolutely a very terrific and wonderful experience. And once a person asked a question to one of these trapeze artists, how you are able to do this, how you are able to achieve this objective, your goal, you are jumping, you are doing wonderful things, you are jumping from one end of the tent to the other end without any help, and of course it is a wonderful experience you are doing, how do you do this? And there was an answer. And the answer from the trapeze artist was, I throw my heart first. What is that? I repeat, I throw my heart first and my body will follow. My body will follow. So as leaders, you are throwing your heart first in setting your goals. If I'm here as a man of 60 years of age, even now I have my goals. I remember a time when I had a goal to be a teacher. Then my goals changed. There are short-term goals as well as long-term goals. My goal was to become a principal of an institution. I achieved my goal. And again, I had other goals. I wanted to be a member of the UGC committee. So I worked for another thing to obtain a higher grade, the NAC accreditation. I achieved that. So all these things, a lot of effort is required. A lot of pain is required. And you have that focus. As already said, that focus is there. That objective is here. Help everybody to establish the goal is the last point here. Helping everybody to achieve your goal. I'm moving. Shall I move to the next slide? I'm moving to the next slide. Here is the definition. Of course, as seniors, this quotation or this definition may be familiar to you. Is it familiar? A goal is a specific end result towards which an effort is directed. Yes? I'm happy that few of you are already defined. Yes or no?
Yes.
As Bharda said, few of you are defined. I'm very happy about the response, because for a trainer, for a teacher, when somebody asks a question, if the children, no, they are not answering, the teacher will not have the energy. So I'm deriving the energy from the participants. No, kallugalodu maratha marathodu alla.
Vaidyan, we have a participant from Orissa, JP. JP from Odisha. And he says, after Corona, all the goal setting formula will change.
Okay, sure, it is possible. Yeah, coming to that. Goal setting, of course, goal settings can always change. It should change. But it should be something like, you know, what do you call do or die? So I was just remembering that Orissa, what is his name? The person from Orissa?
Jay Prakash.
Okay, very nice. You have attended this workshop. There's a person called Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar, Dilip is listening. Dilip is also a teacher and a trainer. There's a person called Julius Caesar. Everybody knows about Julius Caesar. He's a Roman statesman, and he is a military person. And there are so many stories about Julius Caesar. He belonged to the Roman Empire. And this person called Julius Caesar, it is a history also. Julius Caesar has fought so many nations. And once he wanted to go to England, Suryan Astamikyata, British Samrajyam in the Malayalathil Parayam. If you say in English, the country where the sun never sets, that is the great country of British, no? Britain, Great Britain. At that time, it was called the country where the sun never sets. It was a usage. Suryan Astamikyata, British Samrajyam in the Parayam Bowl. When you say the country where the sun never sets, I mean, at that time, it is used because it is a large area, because Britain was considered to be a very powerful nation. It is a history. I'm talking, coming back to Julius Caesar, a great Roman statesman and a fighter and a warrior. He wanted to fight England. And the story is in the website at your fingertips. If you use your mobile on searching the net, you check Julius Caesar, the story comes. Julius Caesar with about 500 to 600 soldiers went in a ship to conquer Britain, the country where the sun never sets. And they landed in a place called Dover Cliff, spelling D-O-V-E-R-C-L-I-F, Dover Cliff. Dover Cliff is also called as the White Cliff. It's in the history. Why it is called White Cliff? Because it is related to my subject, chemistry also. It is called White Cliff at the border of France between England and this and this, there is a canal or there is a sea in between. Dover Cliff is also called White Cliff because it is made up of calcium carbonate, not chalk, or, called chalk. You know chalk, the writing, what we use for writing in the board, that is chalk. Chalk is made of calcium carbonate. It is a chemical. Chalk is a calcium carbonate. So this Julius Caesar wanted to conquer the Britain. And that was an old story maybe years back. And that is not important. The year is not important. This person, Julius Caesar, with a member, with about 600 persons, wanted to conquer Britain. And this person landed in a silent area of Dover Cliff. They landed, they boarded, and their ship was anchored at that time. And the 600 soldiers went into the tent. Of course, they are using the tent. They are sleeping. And at midnight, one of the soldiers could see that the ship was burned off. No, we can see the fire as we see in the movies, in the film. The whole ship was burning to ashes. And the 600 persons in the Dover Cliff, they were sleeping in their tent. And Julius Caesar was also the captain. And the captain or the Roman emperor or the Roman army chief was also sleeping. One of the soldiers called him, "See, our ship is burning. Our ship is a disaster." Now you can imagine the situation. Of course, you can imagine the situation. The ship is lost. They have landed in a country of Britain. And it is a very alarming situation. They are going to die. And there is a great sentence, a great statement by Julius Caesar. Now we have to act. We cannot go back to Italy. We cannot go back to Italy because we are in between the sea, devil and deep sea. He used the word do or die. We have to fight and die. If we win, we can escape because our ship is no more there, because we came in a ship, and that is a story of years back. And the concept is do or die. Why I have used this story when I was explaining on the goal setting, because it's a concept for each one of you. A goal is a do and die policy. Do or die. When you have that focus on that, as I have shown in the first archer, that focus. If you have that goal in your life, it is not a goal of becoming a national president. It is not a goal of becoming a district governor of Lions Club. It is not the goal of becoming a zone president of JCs or a national president of JCs. But whatever is the goal, it is a do or die policy. That's why I have borrowed the story of Julius Caesar, do or die. So my dear friends, it should be a policy of doing do or die. I hope my communication is complete. Is it clear? Hello? Is it clear? Fine. The goal is a specific definition. Goal is a specific end result towards which effort is directed. Now, I have a question for you to answer in your chat box. Which two words which struck you most in this definition? My point, I repeat. Can you write in your chat box two word or at least one word which struck you most in this quote? Ningale swadhinicha ee quotation lere vaaka type yamo chat box la. Varghese will monitor that. Ee quotation la, in this quotation, can you tell me a word which struck you most? Half a minute.
PNP Jairaj want to talk rather than typing.
Sir, let me complete. We have the question answer session at that time. We have an opportunity to talk. I would ask you to write in your, thank you, Jairaj, for the cooperation. Specific is the word. If you ask me, the word which struck me most was specific as well as effort. Specific.
Specificity is a word. Specific, yes. Result.
Yes.
Specific result and effort. Yes. These are the answers.
Fine. Effort. Wonderful.
Result.
I also endorse. If you ask me, can you tell me a word which struck you most in this quote, in this definition of goal, specific as well as effort? Yeah, I'm happy because I got my answer. Teachers always ask a lot of questions, but deriving the right answer is the most important thing for a teacher. You know, there are so many professors and teachers. Dilip is smiling. You see, a teacher asks a question and getting the right answer is the most important thing. So today, again, I got the right answer. Specific. Specific is a word that we use in chemistry also. In catalysis, we use specific catalysis. Specificity means focused, clear, or it is only for a purpose. It is only for a purpose. Purpose oriented, it is specific, it is focused, it is absolutely designed or directed to a point. And that is called a goal. And each one of you should have hold. Don't think that Jairan is a chartered accountant. He is the past district governor of the Rotary Club. Now your goal has not ended. Without pain, there is no gain. The old adage goes like this: without pain, no gain. Every person should have a goal, and if you continue that goal, I move to the next. Clearly defined goals. Can you see me? Can you see it? Yes. Usually in the training, I will ask the participants to read the definition or the quote. I am going to read it for you. In the absence of clearly defined goals, we become strangely loyal to performing daily acts of trivia. See, I have mentioned about clearly defined goals. Can anyone tell me the meaning of this? Or there is a word which is a hard nut to crack. That word is trivia. What is trivia? What is trivia? What is trivia? Yes. Trivia means it is a routine things daily, you know, waking up in the morning, opening the mobile phone, scratching, no, thondi thondi irikya. In Malayalam, we say thondi thondi irina, thendi thendi po. Even the small children, morning you get up, what do you start with? The mobile phone, you are touching in the mobile phone.
Eh? One said silly. Trivia means silly.
Silly things. Getting silly, no value. Getting up in the morning, going to your mobile phone, going to the toilet, after that reading the newspaper, beginning coming back to the television, watching the TV, no reading, no books, nothing. No, without reading, you are going to a big zero. You know that. If you cannot read the newspaper, if you are not able to read a book, you are going to a big zero because you are not opening your door to the world. Of course, we talk that to the children, not to seniors like you. So daily acts of trivia means the routine things. What is the point here? What is the point displayed here in the slide? When you don't have a clearly defined goal, it is like a daily act of trivia. I mean, silly things, routine things, you are doing all those things regularly. I started the discussion today with a word which that should rumble in your ears. I use that word, goal is your source of energy. I'm sure all of you will remember that. Goal is your source of energy. And now I have stated you should have a clearly defined goal. Yes, I have another slide on the board on the slide, and can you read that? Goals lead to a properly directed life. Yes, do you agree with me or not? Hello, you can nod. You can nod at least.
Yeah.
Goals
yes.
Lead. Yes, you know, when you nod or raise your hand like this, no, positive sign. Goals lead to properly directed life and gives us a vision and mission to work upon. There are two words here, vision and mission. I'm not going to talk or take a session on vision and mission because Bharadas can take or talk one day about vision and mission. Vision is a short-term thing as well as mission is a, mission is a short-term thing and vision is a long-term goal. Okay, there should be a vision and mission for everyone. In our school, in our college, in our organization, every organization has a goal, has a mission and vision. Nowadays, we are all tuned in the line. So goals lead to a properly directed life. I was just remembering a person called Napoleon. Napoleon, the full name is Napoleon Bonaparte. You know him, Napoleon Bonaparte. Napoleon Bonaparte is a warrior. He's a French warrior. And he fought so many nations. As all of you know, Napoleon has fought about 62 wars. 62 yuddhangal chedu. He has fought about 62 wars, Napoleon. A great warrior, French commander, Napoleon. And everybody has studied about Napoleon. I have learned about Napoleon Bonaparte in the school days, Napoleon Bonaparte. And Napoleon Bonaparte is a leader having clearly defined goals. And he has fought 62 wars. And the teachers and the seniors know that out of 62, he lost 2. You know the name of the lost wars? Number one, what is that? Can you type in the chat box? One of the wars lost by Napoleon Bonaparte. Can you put in the chat box, please? Chat box. Bharadasji.
Oh, yes, I'm one.
Napoleon Bonaparte lost a war. Lost one of the, he fought 62, but he lost 2. And one of that is a famous war. That war, no response? That is Waterloo.
So far.
Waterloo. Fine.
Waterloo. So many Waterloos.
So who gave Waterloos? Who are Waterloo, the persons?
Three people has already given. Sugathan has come. Rajit Kumar has come. And a person with Vivo mobile has come.
Sujithan, Advocate Sujithan, Ranjit, and who is having Vivo, may I offer them a peg next time when we have the NGB or national event, okay, we are having, you know, instead of the chocolate, as suggested by some PNPs, instead of chocolate, I am going to give the peg, kindly remind me, only otherwise I may not be able to identify. Advocate Sujithan, of course I know. Fine. Napoleon Bonaparte lost over Waterloo and he was sent on exile. You know the meaning of exile, he was sent on, no, sent to an island. And I forgot the island name as Saint Helena, I suppose. Saint Helena. So Napoleon Bonaparte was sent on exile alone in an island called Helena. And he was staying that, no? As all of us are suffering, it is a quarantine. No, it is something like a jail. We are all in quarantine now. We are all in jail. Likewise, years back, Napoleon Bonaparte, the great French commander, was sent on exile to an island. At that time, somebody came, an youngster came, a youth came. May not be a press, pressman or media person, but this person asked a question. The question shot to Napoleon Bonaparte. The question was like this: sir, whatever you touched was converted to gold. That is a golden in Greek mythology. Whatever you touch converting to gold, no? That's a Greek mythology. It is called Midas touch. M-I-D-A-S, you know, that word, Midas touch. Thottavellam, Pornaka, that is a Midas touch. Whatever you touch converted to gold. That's a Greek story. That is a Midas touch. M-I-D-A-S, Midas touch. And this person said, this youth in front of Napoleon, who was on exile in the jail of the island, Saint Helena, the question was asked. And Napoleon was asked, no, facing the question, sir, you have fought so many nations and you are a great warrior, you are a great commander in chief, and you have fought so many wars, you are very successful in winning, not losing, you have always set your goals, and you have left no stone unturned, whatever you touched was converted to gold. Now, tell me, what is your message to the youth around the globe? What is your message for the youth of the persons, I mean, youth across the globe, across the world? Message Taravan Yuju. Can you give a message? And the famous message is at your fingertips, you check your mobile. Napoleon's very famous statement made to this youngster for the question, what is your message for the youth around the globe, across the globe? And Napoleon said, ability is nothing. Inverted commas. Ability is nothing without opportunity. I hope you got that meaning. Ability is nothing without opportunity. When you are getting that opportunity, your ability is poor. We have our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He started as a tea, person who was selling tea in the railway stations and the trains, but slowly, steadily, he became a minister, he became a party president, he became a chief minister, and even displacing Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he became the prime minister and he is identified as a global leader. And the quotation of Napoleon, ability is nothing without opportunity. My dear friends, ability is nothing without opportunity. And of course, that goal setting is important. Now we are moving on to the next. What is the value of establishing your goals? What is the value of establishing the goals? Values. Now, 21st century is a century of excellence. I use the word excellence. Excellence, E-X-C-L-L-E-N-C. In this era of excellence, each one of us should think in a different way. Each one of us should plan in a different way. And of course, we have to establish our goals. Now, here is a question before you. What is the value of establishing goals? Please write in your chat box one word. What is the value of establishing? Not a sentence. Just write a word. What is the value of establishing a goal? Maybe for you, and you can take. Now you can connect it with yourself. What is the value of establishing a goal? I'm sure that each one of you have a goal. Because when we in the classrooms, in the colleges, I usually ask, what is the goal? Many students rise up and say, I have no goal. Parents bring me, pay the fees. They purchase the books. I'm just studying. I don't have a goal. Every time I tell the children, the youth, the youngsters, have a clear goal. And because you have to understand the value of the goal. Fine. Now I would ask you to write down in the chat box, one word answer, the value of establishing the goal. Please do that.
We have attitude to dream on it.
Yes.
That is the aim in life. That is communication. Yes. Dream comes to reality. Yes. Achievement, yes. Of life. Achievement.
Wonderful. Great. Fine, you deserve the chocolate. Value of establishing the goals. By setting goals. My slide, no, all those coming, no, repeatedly. I don't know what happened. Achieve more in your life. We have the answer now. I have asked you the question, now we have the answer. In fact, I wanted to come, you know, all these bullets one by one. I don't know, it is working now. Achieve more. When you have a goal, because I want to get the highest trainership in the Lions movement. I want to get the highest trainership of JC's Excel, or I want to get designer. Yes. And I want to achieve more. That may be, for example, I'm giving you a goal. Achieve more. I want an answer from each one of you, even from all the participants. We have 65 participants now. Achieve more. Can you apply in your life and write in your chat box where you have achieved more by setting a goal? All of you have a goal. All of you have achieved also. Can you clearly text or type in the chat box an example where you have achieved more by setting a goal? And the chodyam clear anallo.
We have comments like hard work and time management.
And no, my point is, can you write down in the chat box one example of yours, which can be shared, an example where you have achieved more in your life. For example, if I say one of my recent achievement was I got the highest trainership, LCIP, Lion Certified International Trainer, you know that. So that was, I have achieved my, I have set the goal, I have worked hard for that. No, throughout, I mean, a lot of effort I have put. That is, if you ask me, by setting goals, how did you achieve more? I achieved an objective, a goal. My training ladder, the biggest achievement as a trainer in the organization. So likewise, I want you to chat, put in your chat box one goal you have achieved.
Dilip says international trainer.
Wonderful. Dilip says
qualifying CA, registers. And Mohan says this is my official character. Career, and here is one doctor saying PhD.
Yes.
These are the
wonderful. By setting goals, you will achieve more. Yes. As I tell you, I repeatedly tell you, it is my delight and pleasure to tell you, by setting goals, no, goal is your source of energy. Without a goal, it is like a ship without a compass needle, you know. When a ship in the vast ocean.
Vaidyan, just a comment. 45 minutes over. You can extend the session as per, but you can plan this just as a.
Okay. Thank you so much. I will go a little more faster. Achieving more is very important. Second one, being successful by setting goals, then increasing our self-confidence. Confidence is very, very important. Confidence is something that propels you to achievement. Self-confidence. I usually tell in the training sessions that confidence has got three legs, stool of self-confidence. Almavishwasathina, moonu kaligal unde. Self-confidence has got three legs. The first leg of self-confidence is appreciate yourself. All of us have, God has given you a lot of blessings. Now, first of all, to increase your confidence, the first thing is appreciate yourself. Second one is you must be more responsible. Responsibility is number two for self-confidence. And the third one is having the skills. I have given you three legs of self-confidence. First leg, feeling responsible. Second leg, feeling appreciated. And the third leg is having. The two of them starts with feeling. And the last one starts with having the skills. Increase the confidence, clear vision, and also reduce the stress also by goal setting. Now again, the quotation which I had repeatedly, goal is your source of energy, your dream, and your state of being. Goal is your source of energy, your dream, and your future state of being. You know, all of us, wherever we go, we caught a person called APJ Abdul Kalam. He has written a book, and that book is a book that all of us should read in the college also. I have purchased more than 50 to 60 copies for the children. Everybody should read this book, APJ Abdul Kalam. Can you tell the name? A beautiful book, Wings of Fire, and then Agni Charangal, Tamil also he translated, Wings of Fire. In particular portion of this particular book on Wings of Fire, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, our former president, says the poor man, the average man of India, is not a person who don't have the money to purchase his square meal. Bashanam vangan panam illathavan alla indiyile paavapattavan. The poor man of our country is not the person who don't have the money to purchase his square meal, but the poor man of our country is the person who is not having a vision, goal and objective. The poor man is a person who is not having a goal and vision. Yes, of course, we should have that goal. It is your dream, it is your future, and it is your state of being. Now, I have the story, the success story of few poor persons who have succeeded in their life. One person is called Mary K. Ash. Mary K. Ash is a famous cosmetic business person in her life. She has succeeded, he has set a goal, and Mary K. Ash is known for cosmetic and other things, and she's succeeded, a very successful person, Mary K. Ash. I want to focus on another person called Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein has a clear goal. He's supposed to be a person who was, no, he did not speak until he was 3 years old. Extremely shy person, and he has brought the famous equation, energy E is equal to mc squared, the famous equation of energy. E is equal to mc squared, energy of, I mean, there's a very valid equation. Albert Einstein had a goal in his life. He is a very shy person, as it is here. Einstein set a goal of becoming a mathematics and physics teacher, and studied on his own at home after school. So that is the story of a person who has succeeded. I can give you another example of Kylian Mbappe. Who is Kylian Mbappe? The great footballer from France, French footballer. His annual income is 1.75 crore of euro, multiply with 50 euro, 1.75 crore. And what's his age of Kylian Mbappe, the great footballer who is good in dribbling the football, French footballer. His income is 1.75 crore euros a year, and he's playing for Paris and a football company, and he's a French football player. And his age, what is his age? He is only 22 years now. Last World Cup, he was 20. Now he is 22. Kylian Mbappe, how did he achieve his goal? It is through continuous practice, and practice. I have so many persons, examples of persons who have succeeded in their life by setting their goals. Because of lack of time, I am moving. This is about Einstein. Einstein got the Nobel Prize. He far exceeded his goal, and 1921 obtained the Nobel Prize. Albert Einstein, the world famous renowned scientist who brought that formula, E is equal to mc squared, mass into velocity, energy squared, even valid now in the 21st century. Goal sets your direction. It doesn't matter where you are, but which direction you are headed. There's a story of a small child, a small baby, 6 years old. 6 years old baby was praying. The child's prayer, you know, God, take care of my father. Small children pray like this. God, take care of my mother. God, take care of my grandma, grandfather. God, take care of my uncle. Take care of my grand auntie and all. The small child was praying. I'm focusing your attention, not about the prayer, but the last part of the prayer of this child of 6 years old, praying, God, take care of my uncle, take care of my father, take care of my auntie. And finally, this small child of 6 years old was praying to God, God, don't forget to take care of yourself, right? What the child said? I'm repeating that. Hello, hope you're following. Don't forget to take care of yourself. Otherwise, all of us are going to be in trouble. Uncle, auntie, everybody is going to trouble. Why people don't reach their goals? Again, all these things are in the slide. They may not have clear time to focus. Sometimes we have a goal, but we don't have sufficient time to focus. Second point, what is that? Goal may be too general. They aren't sure exactly what they should do. Next, they may never have a written goal. I put it in bold letters. There is no written goal. Usually we tell in the leadership training, whatever is your goal, whatever is your objectives, even for the science students, we ask them to put it in the front of the table, equations. Now, a goal should be a written goal. I am sure Our members will listen carefully. You should have a written goal. How many of you have written a goal? You must write a goal, because there should be a written goal. And the last point, what is that? Last point here in the slide. Goal may be too difficult or too easy. Suppose you want to go to Mars. No, going to Mars is a very difficult task. Suppose somebody is fixing a goal. I want to go to Mars is a very difficult thing. So goal may be too difficult. So there are so many cases where people don't reach their goals. I'm coming next. Goals must be smart goals. What is that? It should be specific. A goal should be a smart goal, specific. Then what is that? Second one, measurable. Second one, it should be actionable. It should be performable and it should be realistic. And finally, it should be time bound. It should be time bound. So specific, we take the first letters, SMART. A goal should be smart goal. I'm moving to the next slide. You can give an Excel, but with lack of time. What are your goals? Now, I want all of you to write down 5 goals in the chat box. Or not in your chat box. If you have your book, writing pad, please write 5 of your goals. I give you half a minute. I told you in the beginning, we are going to have a written goals. Please write 5. I will finish up in 10 to 12 minutes. Baradas, I need, can
almost,
I go?
Almost 1 hour.
Now okay, I'll finish in 10 minutes. I'll finish up in 10 to 12 minutes. Fine. I want all of you to please write down 5 goals. Number 1, number 2, number 3, based on the priority. First one is maximum priority. Number 2, less priority. Please write down 5 of your goals. 5 of your goals. The goals can be in senior chamber. The goals can be how I will help my legion, how I will help my country, how I will help the poor people during COVID time, how I will accomplish as a team leader. In any of this connection, you can write down 5 of your goals. Okay. Have you written 5? Wonderful. I'll move. Now I'm going to set the priorities. You have written 5 of your goals. Yes or no? Hello. Hello. 5 of your goals. Okay. 5 goals in order. Now, on the right side of your goal, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, you can sort it out. You have to do it. Must do. Can you see? Must do. Second, should do. And the third, sometimes I'll do, might do. I have asked you to write down 5 of your goals. Okay. Fine. The first goal is the most important. Second, maybe second one or third one. I don't know. You have written your goal. That is a secret. You don't have to put it in your chat box. Now, you have to categorize. You have to prioritize. And we are doing prioritizing our goals. I hope you got the meaning of the word prioritizing. Please write down which is must to do. You can write down on the right side half a minute. Must do, should do, might do. Out of this, you write down which is must do, which is should do, which is might do. I want to have the marriage of my daughter. Okay, must do, honor, should do, honor, might do, honor, you select. I want to purchase a new Maruti Baleno. Must do,
which should do, might do. Want to become a judge in Supreme Court.
Supreme Court. Now, okay, fine, wonderful. She has to write, whoever has given Supreme Court judge, she should write down whether it is must do, should do, or might do. Let us put the priority. What we are doing now? What are we doing now? We are prioritizing our goals, right? You are prioritizing, ordering, prioritizing your goals. Fine. Must do, should do, and might do. I hope all of you have done that. Due to the shortage of time, I am moving to the next one. We have set the goals. Now the previous slide was your goals. You all of you have written 5 goals. Now the second step, you are setting your goals. First step was goal as a member. Second goals setting. Now prioritizing your goals. Okay. You have 5 goals in your sheet of paper writing. But now, yes, goal setting, physical, mental, social, and spiritual. I move developing a plan. There's a story of John F. Kennedy, you know, that was going to moon. Chandrayaan ISRO. There is a great achievement of Indian scientists. and also the lunar orbit of Vikramendra. Okay, now I want you to select one goal. Can you see? What we are going to do now is the planning process. Hello, am I clear to you? Am I boring you or not? Okay, please. Planning process. Select one goal. I put it in red letters. Select one goal now. Okay. I hope you have selected one goal. Out of the five goals, you select one goal. Now, what are you going to do now? You are selecting one goal. Now, on the right side of your goal, which you have selected now, priority, you write down what is the task. What is the task? To have this, accomplish this, what are the challenges? Because, for example, if I want to have the marriage of my daughter, I have to find money. If I want to buy a Volkswagen, I need some money challenges. And on the right side, you will write the solutions. How will you get the solution? I will get a loan from the bank. Okay, like that. I'm giving you the examples. Okay. I have asked you to select a goal. On the right side, if you are cooperating with me, write down the task. Okay, you write the task. I want to purchase a new Baleno in 2 months. Okay, that is a task. Challenges. I don't have money now. I have only little money with me. Okay, fine. What are the solutions? I am giving examples. Okay, it applies to whatever is your goal. It depends on your selection of the goals, right? Selection of the goals. I hope you have done it. Okay, you select a goal. What we have done right now, can you tell me? We have in the planning process of, you have selected a goal, you have written the task, you have found the challenges, and now you have made the solution also. Now, last, I want you to write down what are the resources, the people needed and the materials needed to achieve your goal. I'm going on a scientific approach of achieving of planning process of your goal. For your goal, challenges, solutions, resources, so, how do you achieve this goal?
So, okay. Prof, want you to send me the updated classes with the names and students of key defaulters not attending class in red.
Somebody is talking.
Okay.
Okay. I hope you have done this goal. That was prioritizing, or that is the planning process. So what we have done now, we have selected a goal. We have set the goal. We have done the planning. Finally, we have done the planning. And now we have to make the action plan. Final, last part, action plan. I'm coming to the last part of my seminar, on my presentation. Action plan, that is completing the action plan. How will you achieve my goal? Because there's a great statement by Swami Vivekananda. All of you know that quotation. Awake, arise, and stop not till your goal is achieved. Everybody knows this quote. Awake, arise, and stop not till your goal is achieved. Okay, now you have selected your goal. Okay, what goal is sought? You have done that? Yes or no? Please do that. Second, hello. How it is going to be achieved? Specific steps. Please do that. I'm having only little time, so I'm going little fast. I have increased the pace of my presentation. And next is when each step will be completed. There may be step one. If you want to purchase a car, first step is to get the quotation. Second one is going to the bank. Next one should be taking the loan, like that. When each step is completed. If you want to go for IAS, first of all, you have to get the advertisement. You have to go to the website. You have to write down, fill up the form. You have to get the informations. You have to select the subject. You have to select the specialized subject if you want to write down the UPSC examination for Indian Administrative Service, right? When each step will be completed, date of sending the application, who will be responsible? That is very important. You or your parents, you or your uncle, you or your daughter. And finally, how we will know the completion? Because a smart goal is time bound. Now, goal is the, we have completed the action plan. My dear friends, what we have done today, we have defined the goal. We have set a goal. We had a planning of the goal. We had a planning process. And finally, we had the action plan. We had the action plan. It is a plan, the future state. Yes, practical goals, realistic goal, achievable goals, countable goals, time-bound goals, inspiring, challenging. And of course, it must be logical. Goals must be balanced. Very, very important. Goals must be balanced. Balanced goal is absolutely important. There is a book called Seven Habits of Effective People. Who has written that book? Seven Habits of Effective People. Stephen R. Covey. Very, very important book. Stephen R. Covey has written a book called Seven Habits of Effective People. It is written by Stephen R. Covey, a management. No, he is a professor also. Stephen R. Covey. One of the first points he gives in that book is be proactive. You know the meaning of the word proactive. Okay, I'm not going to that. You must be proactive. Your goal must be balanced. Stephen Covey, in that beautiful book, which all of you should read, mentions about balanced methodology of goal. Balance. Family is important. Financially, it should be balanced. Physically, mentally, socially, and most importantly, spiritual. Setting your objectives. Remember, once you have identified your objectives, you can focus your mind on them. Great quote. You know this. All of us know this. Arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. And this is a message which I want to conclude today with our members. No, you are all very patient and listening to me. Absolutely. This is the quote, the very famous quote of Swami Vivekananda, who made a speech in the United Nations years back. All of you know that. Very young person, very dynamic person. Look at his face. He's radiating glory and confidence. What I said, repeat the word. This Swami Vivekananda radiates glory and self-confidence. Self-confidence is the thing that propels you to action. And Swami Vivekananda spoke in the UN General Assembly on behalf of the great democratic country, India. Arise, awake, and stop not till your goal is achieved. I want to read this quote for you. If you don't go after what you want, you will never have it. I'm sorry, that number crept in. If you don't ask, the answer is always no. If you don't stop for it, you're always in the same place. You want to be in the same place always? No. You must always go forward. Penguin cannot fly. You know, penguins are beautiful birds, but it cannot fly. The wings are stuck. The wings are stuck. The bird cannot fly. The bird is a beautiful bird, but penguin cannot fly. Why? Because the wings are stuck and the penguin cannot fly. You must not be a penguin like a penguin whose wings are stuck. You must be able to fly, and irrespective of your age, you have to set a goal. I will read out this quote for you. Your dreams will continue to call out to you, either softly or loudly, until you acknowledge them and express them in your everyday life. Practice, practice, and practice. Practice, practice, and practice. Reaching your goals. Conclusion. The reason most people never reach their goal, that they don't define them. Today, we have defined our goal. At least you had an idea. You should have a goal. You have defined them seriously and consider them as a believable and achievable goal. Winners can tell you where they are going, what they plan to do along the way, and who will be sharing the adventure with them. Fine. As APJ Abdul Kalam said, your goal is very, very important. I'm concluding. The objective of today's one-hour session, we recognize the value, identify the characteristics. Now we have set a goals. We have set goals. You have written down in your writing pad. Last, we have developed an action plan also. Yes or no? Yes, we have developed an action plan also. My objective of one-hour session is almost over. And thank you so much for your patient listening. I know that I have overshot the time. Maybe I've taken cross the time limit of 1 hour. Sorry if I overshot, but I wanted to say that I have to convey the message as a JC, which I have learned, the concept of perfection and the concept of energy and the concept of self-confidence. I want each one of you to have the goal as a contributing person, as a dominating person. A dominating person, I call them as a contributing person who has the authenticity, number one, A-U-T-H-E-N-T-I-C-T-Y. You must have the authenticity, a contributing person, number one, authenticity, number two, connectivity. What is connectivity? Connectivity is communication. And the third one, the word I have used, that is productivity. I conclude with three words for goal setting: authenticity, second one, connectivity, and what is the third one? That is the productivity. And what is productivity? Productivity is the output, productivity is the outcome. And we want an outcome of this one-hour training seminar, because our national president, our national director of training, as well as the faculty research chairman, has taken a lot of efforts to arrange a webinar like this. And it must be productive. It must be productive. I'm concluding. Goal is your source of energy. Can you repeat? Goal is my source of energy. Goal is my source of energy. Thank you. Thank you very much.